So still with the coronavirus, CBS News has obtained a draft of CDC guidelines for reopening schools. The recommendations are expected to be released later today. And Nancy Cordes is following this for us from the White House. Nancy, this is good news. What do these proposed guidelines include?
Good morning, Anne Marie, and I hope you are having a great early Valentine's.
Lovely. Now I am.
Good to see you. Good to see you from a very festive White House. This is a gift from the First Lady. Lots of hearts out on the lawn this morning. But this is something that so many parents have been waiting and wondering about, right? Guidelines from the federal government about when their children can go back to school and how. So according to the draft guidelines that CBS News has viewed, schools would fall into four color-coded zones. Schools with low community spread would be in the blue and yellow zones. They would reopen with full in-person learning and as much social distancing as possible. Schools in the orange zone, where transmission rates are higher, would be recommended for hybrid or reduced attendance with required distancing. The same guidance goes for schools in the red zone if they regularly test the staff and the students. Now, for red zone schools that don't regularly test, the CDC would recommend elementary schools have reduced attendance with mandatory distancing and that there only be virtual classes for middle and high school students. Now, these guidelines that are being released later today are also expected to include mitigation strategies like masks and hand washing, resources devoted to under-resourced communities, prioritizing teachers for vaccines, and accommodating high-risk educators with virtual teaching or flexible schedules. Officials tell CBS News these guidelines could still change. And one big thing we still don't know, Anne Marie, is what qualifies as low community spreads. What are the rates that would put schools in each of these four different categories?
Still, you know, it's a start. The only thing is that some of these things are going to cost money. The president is expected to speak to governors and mayors today about the economic relief plan. We know that there is a stimulus bill sort of floating out there. What's going on with that in Congress?
So parts of that bill continue to be written, and they are making their way through the legislative process in the House. The goal is to get each piece of the legislation written, and each piece needs to be written in a different committee depending on what it's about. And then it would be ready to go for review by the House and the Senate after this impeachment trial wraps up, which is really monopolizing all of the Senate's time. And the goal still is to hold a vote by the end of February, if possible, because what Democrats are really concerned about is that if they let this process play out much longer, then states are not going to have enough time to adjust their unemployment systems before federal unemployment assistance is set to run out altogether on March 14th. So they want to try to get in early, give the states time to adjust.
Yeah, they're definitely going to need to do that. Nancy, thank you so much. And yeah, the hearts are great. That's definitely needed on this Friday.
Love to you.